How has evolved innovation policy in the Nordic countries?
Yes, well, in the Nordic countries, as elsewhere in Europe and in the world, innovation policy is a relatively new term. So before the 1990s, very few people talked about innovation policy. But innovation policies, in the meaning of policies that have an impact on innovation, they are much older. And so if you look for them, you will find them. And in that sense, I think, especially in Sweden, but also in Norway, innovation policy was well in existence and important already in the 1960s. While it came later in Denmark and Finland. But since then it has subsequently evolved. Finland is today perhaps the country that in the world that has had the greatest emphasis on innovation policy during the last 10 to 20 years or so. Mm-hmm.
And one thing, why the innovation policy in Nordic countries is a role model?
Well, it's the world role model is a difficult one because all countries are different. Their innovation systems are different, their patterns of specializations are different, and their histories and institutions are different. So that means that there also be a lot of differences also in innovation policy. And that's quite natural. But if it is a role model, it's a role model in the sense that this has been taken very seriously. And the whole setup of the system and the institutions related to innovation policy has underwent important changes. Maybe in that sense.
And why is so important the collaboration between private and public institutions?
It is important because innovation is not only about what happens inside firms. I mean, if a firm should only rely on its own knowledge, it would rely on a very, very small piece of something that is much bigger. So for firms just to be inward looking would be to shoot oneself in the foot, right? So firms also depend on knowledge from other firms, but also from public sector institutions, universities, research institutes, and so on. So that's why that cooperation is important.